Trigeminal neuralgia. Trigeminal neuralgia affects the fifth cranial nerve. It is usually unilateral and is more common in women over the age of 50. Etiology includes idiopathic, demyelination, or vascular malformations. Additional etiology theory includes pathologic cavities at the site of previous tooth extraction, periodontal lesions, and previous endodontic therapy. We should differentiate the pain of trigeminal neuralgia and any dental origin. Usually, patients came to see a neurologist after received treatment from a dentist. They thought it was the dental origin. They may ask for dental extraction as the pain is killing them. Failure to differentiate can result in significant unnecessary dental extraction and irreversible neurosurgical procedures. The majority of patients describe the classic high-intensity, triggerable pain in association with such activities as eating and talking. Even minor stimuli, such as a cold breeze, can trigger a pain episode. The pain often described as sharp, shooting, or like an electric shock. The pain could be present in any branches of the trigeminal nerve, the forehead, ophthalmic branch, cheek, maxillary branch, and lower jaw, mandibular branch. It usually distributed on maxillary or mandibular branches and limited to one side of the face. The pain associated with trigeminal neuralgia represents an irritation of the nerve. The cause of the pain usually is due to contact between a healthy artery or vein and the trigeminal nerve at the base of the brain. This places pressure on the nerve as it enters the brain and causes the nerve to misfire. Other causes of trigeminal neuralgia include the pressure of a tumor on the nerve or multiple sclerosis, which damages the myelin sheaths. The development of trigeminal neuralgia in a young adult suggests the possibility of multiple sclerosis. The most common pattern of vascular compression by the superior cerebellar artery is along the superior shoulder of the root entry zone. This first figure shows the trigeminal nerve is compressed by the main trunk of the superior cerebellar artery and its branches. The second figure shows combined compression by the superior cerebellar artery and anterior inferior cerebellar artery. This figure shows the nerve is sandwiched between the trigeminal and petrosal veins. The last figure shows the nerve is compressed by the superior petrosal vein. Among all the offending vessels, the superior cerebellar artery is the most common, 75%, followed by the anterior inferior cerebellar artery, 10%. In addition, a vein may contribute to the compression, and sometimes it is the only compressing vessel, 12%. Because of the lamination pattern of fibers within the nerve root, medial compression tends to cause the maxillary division symptoms. Lateral or caudal compression may cause mandibular division symptoms, and rarely, cranial compression causes ophthalmic division symptoms. If you find this video helpful, please hit the subscribe and bell buttons. And don't forget to like and share this video. Thanks.